Anjem Choudary has been released from prison on licence after serving half of a 5.5-year prison sentence for encouraging Muslims to join the so-called Islamic State group. Let's get some immediate reaction to this from Nikita Malik, the director of the Centre of Radicalisation and Terrorism at the Henry Jackson Society. Good morning.
Good morning.
So, your response to his release?
So we've been expecting his release for a while, and I think we have to be very cautious because this was an individual who inspired what we think is hundreds of people to go and join Islamic State. And he also, in many of his rallies at the peak of his time, inspired individuals in the English Defense League. So we had a lot of reciprocal extremism. He was an incredibly charismatic and dangerous recruiter, one of the founders of Al-Muhajirun, in doing that. So as a result, now that he has been released, he will be on very strict security measures. He will be on very strict surveillance. And I think after he has been released, we just have to get on, really, and not give him that kind of media attention that he so craved at his peak.
So, yes, given that we can be certain that he'll be followed and watched very closely and that his assets have been frozen as well, would you consider him to be a threat?
Yes, I mean, I think he is a threat because at its peak, when he was part of Al-Muhajirun, him and his wife inspired what we know are hundreds of people, but could have actually been many more because they targeted families, and many of these families would go and then want to join Islamic State, and gave him almost a celebrity cult-like status. So I think as an individual, he is still dangerous, particularly since he has only served half of his sentence, and it is very difficult to, or perhaps impossible, to de-radicalize somebody in such a short time. There are also particular spaces which he will be watched. So the online space is a very important one, especially since he was finally arrested because he pledged allegiance to the Islamic State in a YouTube video. That will be very important. And looking at it in a larger perspective, we have to also understand that now that the Islamic State has declined and Al-Muhajirun is not as popular as it used to be, there will still be the attraction of a radical ideology. And we need to ensure that these families and these people that were attracted to what he stood for and his message, we really target them and ensure that this doesn't happen again.
And is there any prospect of rehabilitation for Anjem Choudary? I don't know how much you know about what sort of education he might have received while he's been in Belmarsh jail, about whether he's still holds those beliefs that he had when he went in there.
Well, essentially, it can be broken down into two parts. The first is that he served time in an independent prison unit. And this is a debate that the government has been having for some time. It is incredibly dangerous to put an individual like him with the normal prison population because there's a huge overlap between criminals and terrorists. And you're essentially giving criminals who are interested in violence an ideology to ascribe to. So he did spend some time in an independent unit. The second is he would have been given what the government has, which is channel mentorship. So he would have had one-on-one training with somebody who used to hold radical beliefs, or a imam, or someone who would have been able to train him and speak to him one-on-one about why his beliefs are incorrect. And the third part is really that, given the government's recent counterterrorism strategy, there is a advanced version of this which looks at rehabilitation in a stronger sense. But this is very new, and actually I don't really know that much about it. I don't think many people do who are not part of the security services. So we are, from what I can understand, we are working to advance these and make it more concrete,
right?
Because we need it.
Thank you very much, Nikita Malik. It's fine.